Hello, everybody, what's going on? This is Will here, and my voice got a bit scratchy for like a second there. Good lord, Will. In the last episode of Metroid Prime 2 Echoes, we discovered a little shortcut, and we also uncovered the Sunburst, a special super missile equivalent of the Light Beam, which is super awesome. It's, man, I have to say, I was excited that those sort of power-ups returned in this game. That is really cool. Go. Although I feel like I've gotten the Dark Beam one before, but maybe not. I feel like I have. Yeah, but anyway. So let's see what's in here. Okay, so we've got Super Missile Door up where? Up somewhere. And we've also got, okay, so we got Spider Ball tracks over here. I don't even know if this is really where we need to go, but I just kind of figured this would be the best place to start. Again, I'm not sure if that's actually true or what. But, oh, okay, so we start here, and then we'll boost ball our way up there. And then we'll boost ball over across, and then climbing. Okay, so this is straightforward enough. Again, I still don't know if this is really where we need to go, but... Ooh, look at this, we have a little spider ball freeway here. That's nice. So we'll just go, I assume we go like behind the... Or what? Oh my lord. Oh, okay, so... I didn't realize there's a platform there. Duh, Will. So that statue will move out of the way. Revealing. Nice. A super missile door. Alright. They're not a super missile door. I wish. There we go. Give me that missile expansion. Nice. We're at 120 now. Still behind in how many we should have. I think we're supposed to have like 145 or 150 at this point. So, I mean, that's disappointing, but... Oh, well. So let's see what's in here, because this is uncharted territory, dude. This is completely... Whoa. Fortress transport access? Is that what that was? We got, oh geez, we got like Reznor doors here. They're Reznor doors. Reznor platforms. They're just like carouseling. Look at this crap. Oh my lord. Goodness gracious. So we'll go on up here. Perfect. Perfect. So we'll scan that. Sanctuary. Oh! This is a shortcut to Sanctuary. Dude, we are kind of going the original Metroid Prime route now. Where we're finding, like, shortcuts into different parts of areas. That's awesome. Hopefully we'll find more of those. Love it when the game... Well, I think we've already done it. We had, we were able to find, like, an alternate entrance to, Aegon Wastes earlier in the game, didn't we? So I guess it's already kind of started, eh? But let's see where we are, because... Whoa! We are in, like, a completely different part. Oh, no, we're on the other side of... Wait, what? Actually, I don't really know where we are, honestly. Oh, we have to get up to that question mark, too. Oh, good lord. We've got some exploring to do, though. Holy moly, dude. We're in, like, a whole different sector. Oh, these nasty things. Oh, gross. Ew, ew. The way they just break apart, man. That's so gross. Give me that. Give me that power bomb. Oh, God, man. Oh, it's the crappiest thing today, guys. He's just... Oh, man. It's just one of the... Well, not the crappiest thing, but... You know. Definitely one of the things that kind of throws your day in a different direction than you wanted. I was supposed to work at 3 today. And... Co-worker called in and asked me to work till 2, pretty much. Because he has to move off to New Brunswick. He's taking a trip over there, so... He needed some extra time because he's supposed to be there. What time did he say? I think he said 5 he has to be there, I'm pretty sure. Which, you know, it sucks, I guess, but I'm more than happy to help him out. He's definitely one of the cool co-workers there, so I'm more than okay with helping him out. But you know. It's just when you're working on the weekends and, you know, you only have, like, the one day a week to yourself, and then all of a sudden your work day just ends up being longer than it's supposed to, you know? It's one of those things you hoped didn't happen. We gotta shoot these guys with dark feet. They'd stay still and stop strafing. We got some spider ball things we gotta do here. There's lots of spider ball stuff going on now. Oh, whoa, geez. Okay, so those things are trying to kill me. There we go, nice. And... okay, cool. Alright, I'll take it. I'm fine with missiles. You know, they don't immediately help me, but... I like missiles, so I'm totally okay with that. We'll go, wait. How am I not scanning this thing? Oh, it can't be... dude, that's such a standout detail of this room. That big, glowy, orange ball. Why wouldn't you want to scan that, you know? Oh, well, wait, there's a portal down there. Oh, it's blocked off by the door. Right. Okay. Well, that's fine, then. And, oh god, I'm being attacked by a turret. There we go. And you're done. Like dinner. So we've got more little streams of whatever these things are. I guess it's Phazon, is it? Or, ooh, it's just light. Oh, I'm blind. Blinded by the light. Revved up. Like, ugh, jeez. Oh man, the freaking song. It sounds like he's saying revved up like a douche. I just, oh my lord. I know that it's some kind of like old term for like a car. I forget what the actual word is though, because I've spent all my life making jokes about it being douche that I actually forget what the real lyric is. Rev up like a douche in the... see, like, that's just what I associate it with now. I remember this thing Jordan and I always used to say when Jordan started playing through... or no, after Jordan played through Tales of Vesperia. Which I was actually very surprised to figure out that he enjoyed, because Jordan's usually not a fan of JRPGs. But he played through it all, and for the longest time, he like always just talked about how much of a jerk Duke was at the end of the game. Because, spoilers, Duke is the bad guy. so I just thought it was always really funny to... oh, you know what? This entire room is made of... yeah, this entire room is made of Denzium. Oh my god, that is amazing. Look at that, now we can just leave. Just screw it, man. We're out of here. Screw the portal. Oh, good. Oh god, what is this? Well, first of all, what's that? Yeah, so Jordan would always say, instead of calling things a douche during this time, he would call things a duke. He'd just be like, man, what a duke. Because he thought Duke was such a jerk in that game. I don't remember what grade that would have been in, though. That would have been in, I don't know, actually. I think that would have been in grade 11. I think it was grade 11 he played through it, and then for me it would have been summer of grade 11. Or, like, summer of grade 10 going into grade 11. I played it. I think. I'm pretty sure. Okay. But anyway, I always thought that was kind of funny. Just one of the funny little things that I'm sure Jordan has probably forgotten about by now, but I always thought was just really funny. That happens a lot with me and my friends. My friends forget about things that I think are still funny, so I just end up thinking things are funny longer than everyone else. it's a tragic, rare condition, guys. We're gonna go through here, and let's see what this is. Access to Aegon Waste. Whoa, what? Now we're just looping all the way around. Okay, so let's go to Aegon Waste, apparently. I have no idea what we're doing right now. Ooh, the coffee's good this morning. It's very good. This morning, I say at like 11:36. Okay, so where does this take us? Oh, is that it? Are you kidding me? Man, these are hardly, like, worthwhile secrets. Oh, what's this? Elevator system online, okay. Well, I guess you could have just accessed that from any way, hey? So is there anywhere in... there's one room in Aegon we haven't been to yet. Oh no, there's two! Oh my gosh! Okay, I know I said that this episode wasn't going to be like all about like backtracking crap, but that might be too far of a jump. Man, seriously? I think it might be. No, maybe not. If I can find a way to nab that center one. These areas are so small, like, now that I've been to all the other areas. Like, this is such a tiny place. Like, the easiest friggin' place to navigate ever. If these things would piss off. Where are they? Stop targeting stupid crap. There, okay. I think this is also a Denzium wall, isn't it? It is. Cool. Let's open that up. Whoa, a Morph Ball launcher. Ooh, where's that gonna take? Okay. Whoa, jeez. Man, I'm just discovering stuff all over the place. Look at me go. Woo! Aw, yeah, man. There's a missile expansion if I ever saw one. Look at me go. Look at that. Well, we're getting closer then, I guess. We're getting closer to the total we should have. I'm pretty sure it's... It actually might be a lower amount, or a higher amount now. Because, like, I'm sure that mentioned on the guide, they probably have, like, a bunch more missiles already listed that you can get. Now that you have the power bombs. So who knows, maybe I'm just really far behind now. Because I haven't memorized every single Denzium object in this game. There we go, I hate when those things hit me. I don't know why, it's not even a bad thing if they hit you, but... Because they do, like, no damage. I think it's more the fact that they are just, like, honestly really easy to avoid. So when I don't avoid them all, I just kick myself over it. Anyway, get the war wasps the hell out of here. We'll end the episode after this, too, because this is... All these friggin' Metroid Prime episodes, dude, they're so annoying to edit now. Because I just keep having to, like, cut between points because I'm, like, traveling halfway across the world in every episode. Which is more my fault, but... Eh. Still ticks me off. That my intuition is doing this to me, man. Okay, so we'll go on over here. I'm pretty sure it's just like a straight go at it. There we go. Perfect. So, we will fire off on all these. And that didn't work because I was too close. All right, Wind Waker Boomerang, do your work. Nice. Very nice. See, like, I don't think I've ever been in this part. Because I never would have thought to go back this far. Or wait, no, actually. I think I might know this one. I think I might, yeah. Oh my god, I do remember this puzzle. I specifically remember this puzzle. Oh my lord, man. I can't believe I remember this. Oh my god. So what you have to do is you have to use this propeller to break the wall, and that's a dark portal there. And this is also Denzium, I believe. Another thing I wasn't able to break my first time playing through the game, so let's break that. Yeah, see, because I never knew this was here. Well, I mean, I knew it was here, I guess I just never accessed it. So let's go in here and see what's going on. Oh, yeah! Missile expansions! Everywhere, man! Okay, in the next episode, we're going to solve this puzzle, because I vaguely remember this one. So, I will see you all in the next episode. Peace. Yes, Powerbomb!